Today we'll be studying one more type of special concrete, that is high strength concrete. So till now we have discussed with the self compacting concrete, lightweight concrete and ready mix concrete. So in this video we'll be studying the high strength concrete. So introduction. So concrete has become an essential item, that is essential material, especially in the field of civil engineering, because for all the type of civil engineering construction, so we require concrete. So as you all know, so concrete is the second most consumed material in this world after water. So you can just imagine how concrete the development of concrete has evolved, starting from lime mortar. Then after the advancement of after the introduction of OPC in 1824, so the concrete, the manufacture of concrete has taken a diverse change. So whatever they used to prepare, so compared to that, concrete have been evolved from the from that period onwards. So as you all know, for all the type of civil engineering construction, we require concrete. So what is the disadvantage of concrete? So concrete is very good in resisting compression, but it is very weak in resisting tension. So that's why in the tension zone in the concrete structure, we have we are using the reinforcement bars. Why we are using that reinforcement bar in the tension side? Because concrete is very weak in resisting tensile strength. So that's why, to improve the tensile property of the concrete, so we are placing a reinforcement bar in the tension zone, so that concrete take cares of the compressive strength, whereas steel take cares of both compressive as well as the tensile strength. So that's why we have since concrete is weak in tension, we have used the reinforcement bars in combination with the concrete, so that it can able to gain the tensile strength. Okay, so imagine if concrete have not used reinforcement bars. Okay, so if the concrete is very good in resisting, say both good in compression and tension, so we could have reduced the cost of it, we could have reduced the time of construction, and structure would be durable without having any corrosion issues. Okay, so if the concrete would have been good in both resisting compression and tension, then we could have saved these things, that is we could have saved the time, we could have saved the money, and the structure would be more durable, because since there is no reinforcement in the concrete, then there will be no corrosion issues at all. So these are the things that we could have able to achieve if the concrete has good in both compression and tension. But unfortunately, concrete is very good in resisting compression, but it is not good in resisting tension. Concrete strength is gained through curing due to heat of hydration. So as I already told, if you know that curing and all, we have studied already. So curing means what? So after, once the concrete has been placed, okay, once we remove the formwork, so all this cement particles have to be hydrated. So then only we can able to achieve the good strength. If there is no moisture in the concrete after once the formwork is removed, then the cement particles will not be completely hydrated. So then it affects the strength and durability aspects of the concrete. So that's why concrete strength is gained through curing. If all the cement particles get hydrated, then we'll able to achieve good strength. Okay, so concrete strength is gained through curing due to heat of hydration. So that's why the hydration of cement is very important. That is, this all this cement particles have to be hydrated to get the good strength. So if all the cement particles have to get hydrated, means we have to wait for certain days. Okay, maybe 7 days, maybe 14 days, or maybe 28 days, depending upon our construction aspects. Say if the curing would have been done fast, okay, so if curing would have been done first, we could have gained early strength, so which we can help in the early construction. We could have done a very fast construction. Okay, if curing could have been done very fast, if curing could have been accelerated, then we could able to achieve early strength so that we can able to complete the building very fast. Okay, so compaction plays an important role in uniformity. Okay, as you all know, compaction has to be done thoroughly. So with minimum efforts, we need to compact the concrete very well to achieve good compressive strength. All the there should not be any air voids entrapped in the concrete. So with minimum effort, we need to compact the concrete so that we can able to achieve good strength by removing the air voids. So if compaction could have been achieved without vibrators, okay, or concrete could be cast without reinforcement bars, it could provide uniformity. That is, imagine if the compaction could have been achieved without using any vibrators, so if or without using any reinforcement, if the concrete could have been achieved good strength, so then we could have saved a lot of time and money, and the structure would have been good both in terms of strength as well as in terms of durability. Low water cement ratio leads to high compressive strength, but also to low workability. That is, if the water content ratio is low in the concrete, so obviously, you know, Abraham's law, if the water cement ratio is inversely proportional to the strength, if the water cement ratio is low, then the strength will be more. But if you take in terms of workability, if there is no water cement ratio, if the water cement ratio is low, then you will not able to achieve the workability, right? You will not able to mix, place, compact, transport the concrete with ease, because if the water cement ratio is low, we know that the strength will be improved, but what in terms of workability? In terms of workability, we could not able to achieve good workable concrete if the water cement ratio is low. Okay, so these are some of the disadvantages in the concrete in terms of reinforcement bars, in terms of curing, in terms of compaction, in terms of low water cement ratio. All these some disadvantages in the concrete has led to the new development of a new concrete called as high strength concrete. Okay, so these are some of the problems that we face in a normal concrete. Okay, in a normal concrete, these are the problems that we generally face with the reinforcement bars, or with the curing, with the compaction, and with the low water cement ratio. These are some of the problems that we face. Okay, so because of these advantages in the concrete, so we could able to develop a new material called as a high strength concrete. So high strength concrete, we usually call it as HSC. So high strength concrete and HPC, that is high performance concrete, both are not same. Okay, because strength and the performance of the concretes are a different properties. Okay, so we can say high strength concrete means concrete is defined based on its strength. Okay, whereas high performance concrete means it depends on so many aspects, because it is in high performance concrete we are seeing the behavior of concrete, how it is performing, like in the fresh state as well as in the hardened state, how the concrete has been behaved. So that is, or how the concrete has been performed. So that is the high performance concrete. Whereas high strength concrete is mainly defined based on the compressive strength at a given age. Okay, so don't get confused with HSC and HPC. Both are not same. Both it is different. So in this, we are discussing only about HSC. So high strength concrete may be defined as concrete with the specified characteristic cube strength, that is FCK, not F-CK, it is FCK. So if FCK is ranging between 60 to 100 Newton per mm square, then we can say that those type of concrete as a high strength concrete. Okay, so the concrete which is casted if the characteristic cube strength of the concrete is ranging in between 60 to 100 newton per mm square, then we say those type of concrete as a high strength concrete. Okay, even the strength up to 80 to 100 is also can be easily achieved in the site work as well as in the precast works. Even higher strength of grade, high strength grade of concrete can be used, that is in the both precast as well as in the in situ concrete work, that is inside work. HSE is reduced by reducing HSE is increased by, sorry, it is there as reduced. So high strength concrete is can be increased by reducing the porosity. So reducing the porosity means will change, give me a minute, otherwise you will get confused. So high strength concrete is increased by reducing the porosity. Porosity means there should not be having any pore spaces, there should not be having any voids, okay, and internal micro cracks. So HSE can be increased, that is the strength of the concrete can be increased by reducing the porosity and by reducing the micro cracks in the cement paste. So okay, if you take cement paste, so cement paste also will develop a crack due to this. It is not a shrinkage crack, okay, shrinkage cracks, whereas you can see the cracks, whereas micro cracks it will be developed in the paste, especially at the time of cement hydration. So this HSE can be improved by reducing the porosity, that is by reducing the pores in the overall volume of the concrete, and by reducing the internal micro cracks in the cement paste, we can able to achieve the high strength. So the methods and technology for producing high strength concrete are same as that of a normal strength concrete. Whatever the methods that we use to prepare a normal concrete in terms of mixing or in terms of compaction or in terms of any other process of concrete, whatever the methods that we are doing or whatever the technology that we are using to prepare a normal strength concrete, it is same for high strength concrete also. There is no substantial different from that of a normal strength concrete. Okay, whereas the target water cement ratio should be in the range of 0.30 to 0.35 or even lower. So as per Abraham's law, lower the water cement ratio, higher will be the strength. So here in the high strength concrete, we are using water cement ratio in the range of 0.30 to 0.35 or even lesser than 0.30 also. So you may have a question. So if the water cement ratio is lower, then definitely theory says the strength will be high. But what about in terms of workability? So if you use low water cement ratio, whether the concrete will be workable enough to mix, place, compact and transported. So that is why due to low water cement ratio, it causes problem of placing. Okay, not only in terms of placing, it also causes problem in terms of mixing, in terms of transporting also. There will be a lot of problems if you use a low water cement ratio. So to overcome these problems, we are using admixture, that is we are using super plasticizer, that is high range water reducer admixture we are using, so that whatever the, even if we use a low water cement ratio with the admixture, concrete can be made easily workable. Okay, so the main application for high strength concrete, that is it is used in offshore structures, that is in the terms of sea, where there will be a lot of tides. If you are constructing any structure against the tides, so then there you require a high strength concrete. Then columns for tall buildings and long span bridges and other highway structure. So in these kind of applications where you require high strength, so there we can use these kinds of concrete, especially in the offshore structure where you require high strength to resist the tidal waves. There you require this kind of concrete. And for the columns for tall building, where ultimately the load will be transferred through columns to the footing. So the column should be strong enough in the tall building. So there we can use these kind of concrete. And in terms of long span bridges and in other highway structures, we can go for these kinds of concrete, that is high strength concrete. So why do we need a HSC, that is high strength concrete? If you want early age strength, okay, if you want the strength at a minimum, say at a rate of 1 day or 3 days, then we can go for high strength concrete. Reducing section size. So here in a normal concrete, say for example, if I can give is the beam size. So usually beam size 300 by 450 or 300 by 600 or sometimes 300 by 300. So depending upon the structural requirement. So if you see the beam sizes for a normal concrete based on the requirement, we are going for these beam sizes, that is 300 by 300, 300 by 450 or 300 by 600. By using high strength concrete, we can able to reduce the size of the beam section, okay, because the concrete strength is more. If the concrete strength is less, okay, if a normal concrete strength is, if the concrete strength is less, then we have to increase the size of the beam size, okay, or if you have to increase the size of any other structural component if the concrete grade is minimum. Since we are using high strength concrete, so we can able to reduce its section size, okay. And third one, large span structures. In the large span structures of beams or in the bridges, in the dams, we can go for this high strength concrete. And enhanced mechanical properties. So by using high strength concrete, the strength property of the concrete will be enhanced, it will be improved, and also the durability aspects of the structure will also be improved, okay. And also by using high strength concrete, the tensile strength of the concrete also will get improved compared to a normal concrete. So whatever the disadvantages that we find in the first slide, in the introduction slide, all these disadvantages can be overcome by using the high strength concrete. Ingredients. What are the ingredients? Oh, as I already told, whatever the methods and technology that we have used to prepare a normal strength concrete, in the similar way we are going to prepare the high strength concrete, but with some materials extra compared to a normal concrete. So cement we use in a normal concrete, sand also will be using, water, so it is low water cement ratio, whereas for a normal concrete we are not using low water cement ratio. So here for high strength concrete we have to use low water cement ratio, okay. And the size of the aggregate, in the normal also it was in between 10 to 20, here also in between 10 to 20, whereas in normal concrete we are not using silica fume, only where we require high strength then only we are using this silica fume, okay. So silica fume is also called as micro silica is also called as silica fume. So it can be used to enhance the strength at the higher levels. So especially if you want the strength in more than M80, so if you want the strength more than 80 newton per mm square, we can go for this silica fume, because in silica fume it contains almost more than 90% of the silica in it. So what is the main role of silica? It will give the strength to the concrete, okay. So in silica fume, the silica percentage is more than 90%. So definitely it will be used to enhance the strength more than M80. And the average size of the silica fume, okay, it is in the range of 0.15 micron. Okay, so the average diameter of a micro silica is about 0.15 micron. Okay. So 0.15 micron means you can just calculate in terms of mm. So that much is the particle size of the micro silica. Okay. So but it is generally not needed for a lower end, that is in between 60 to 80 MPa, this usually this kind of silica fume is not used, okay. Whereas the particle size of the cement is approximately smaller than 45 microns. Okay, so whereas silica fume, the size of the cement silica fume is in around 0.15 microns. Okay, so you can see the difference between silica fume as well as cement. So finer the size of the particle, then higher will be the strength. Okay, finer the size of the particle, higher will be the strength. Okay, so you remember this. So since silica fume is the diameter size of the particle size of silica fume is smaller compared to that of silica cement compared to that of cement, it will improve its strength at for a higher level. Next, water reducing agents. As already told, since we are using low water cement ratio, then to make it workable enough, so we have to use some admixture, that is super plasticizer. So we have to use super plasticizers or high range water reducers should be used to achieve maximum water reduction. Okay, so since we are using low water cement ratio, so we have to use some admixture so that it should not affect the workability. Whereas although plasticizers may be adequate for lower strength HSC, that is in between 60 to 80 MPa, by using low water cement ratio and with the help of admixtures, we can able to achieve the strength in between 60 to 80 MPa. Whereas if you want the higher strength of higher strength more than M80, then we can go for a silica fume. Advantages. So the advantages of high strength concrete is reduction in the member size. As already told, since the strength of concrete is in the higher side, we can able to reduce the section size of the structural components. Okay, reduces amount of steel. Since the concrete is only very good in resisting compression and tension, okay, in the high strength concrete, we can able to reduce the quantity of the steel in the concrete structure. Okay, since the concrete strength is only more in terms of strength, high strength concrete, as a word say, the strength of the concrete itself is on the higher side, we can able to reduce the steel. So it can take care of both compressive and the tensile property of the concrete. Okay, next, reduces dead load. Since we are using high strength concrete, since we are reducing the section size, so obviously the self weight of the structure will be reduced. Then increases in the plinth area due to thinner members. So plinth area is the surrounding area. Okay, so since we are using smaller sections, so obviously the plinth area of the plinth area will be increased because of the smaller size of the section. High compressive strength, as the word say, high strength, so the strength is in between 60 to 100, it is the high strength. So obviously since the strength is more, the compressive strength as well as the tensile strength both will be more in the high strength concrete. And to use the concrete service at early age, so if you want the concrete strength to be achieved at 1 day or 3 days, then we can go for this kind of concrete, that is high strength concrete. Whereas for a normal concrete, you have to wait till 28 days to achieve almost 100% or 90 to 100% of the strength. If you want to achieve, you have to wait till 28 days. Whereas in terms of high strength concrete, we can able to achieve its strength at a very early age. So low creep and shrinkage. So creep is nothing but it is a time dependent strain due to continuous loading. Okay, so time dependent loading. So here, because of high strength concrete, so the time dependent loading, that is a time dependent strain, also will be reduced, and also the shrinkage also will be reduced. Shrinkage means it is a volume change in the volume changes in the concrete. Okay, so the volume of the concrete should not change because of the surrounding environment. So the volume of the concrete should not change. If the volume changes, then only there will be a development of cracks. So because of high strength concrete, the both creep and shrinkage will be low. Disadvantages: damaged at high temperature, that is less resistance to fire. Okay, so it has no resistance to fire. If the at a higher temperature, so this building may get damaged because of the high strength concrete, because it doesn't have any resistance to fire. And must be expertise in selection of the ingredients. So while selecting the material, we have to be taken proper care at the time of selecting the material. We should be expertise in selecting the ingredients for the high strength concrete. These are some of the disadvantages.
High strength concrete. High strength concrete is a type of concrete which has compressive strength of 60 MPa or greater. The compressive strength is generally measured on 150 into 300 mm or 100 into 200 mm test cylinders, generally at specific age depending upon the application. Some of the basic concepts in preparing high strength concrete are: aggregates used must be strong and durable. Generally, small size aggregates are used for making high strength concrete. High strength concrete generally uses low water cement ratio, which ranges from 0.23 to 0.35. Thus, superplasticizers are added to obtain the desired workability. The total cement content for this type of concrete is should not be more than 650 kg per meter cube, as high cement content results in cracking due to hydration. Sometimes to obtain the desired strength, cement is mixed with supplementary materials like fly ash, ground granulated blast furnace, natural pozzolanic materials, etc., are added. In addition, the components of the design mix like mix proportioning, the shape of aggregates, supplementary cementitious materials, and superplasticizers should be given special care while designing. The most common applications are: to put the concrete into service at a much earlier age, for example, opening the pavement at 3 days. To build high-rise buildings by reducing column sizes and increasing available space. To build the superstructures of long-span bridges and to enhance the durability of bridge decks. To satisfy the specific needs of special applications such as durability, modulus of elasticity, and flexural strength. Some areas of use are dams, grandstand roofs, marine foundations, parking garages, and heavy-duty industrial floors. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. The best is yet to come. Kindly.
So I hope you understood about high-strength concrete. That is, what are its how the high-strength concrete is prepared, what are its advantages, what are its disadvantages, and where are its uses, and how the high-strength concrete have been evolved compared to a normal strength concrete. So these are the things that you have studied under this topic. I hope you understood. Thank you.